an old sailor my grandfather knew, who had so many things which he wanted to do, that whenever he thought it was time to begin, he couldn't because of the state he was in. He was shipwrecked and he lived on an island for weeks, and he wanted a hat and he wanted some breeks, and he wanted some nets or a line and some hooks for the turtles and things which you read of in books. And thinking of this, he remembered a thing which he wanted for water, and that was a spring. And he thought that to talk to he looked for, and keep, he found it a goat or some chickens and sheep. And because of the weather he wanted a hut with a door to come in by, which opened and shut with a jerk, which was useful if snakes were about, and a very strong law to keep savages out. He began on the fish hooks, and when he gone, he decided he couldn't because of the sun. So he knew what he ought to begin with, and that was to find or to make a large sun-stopping hat. Making the hat with some leaves from a tree, when he thought, I'm as hard as a body can be, and I've nothing to take for my terrible thirst. So I'll look for a spring, and I'll look for it first. Then he thought as he started, oh dear and oh dear, I'll be lonely tomorrow with nobody here. So he made in his notebook a couple of notes. I must find some chickens, and no, I mean goats. He had just seen a goat which he knew by the shape, when he thought, I must have a boat for escape. But a book means a sail, which means needles and thread. So I'd better sit down and make needles instead. He got on a needle, but thought as he worked that this was an island where savages lurk. Sitting safe in his hut, he'd have nothing to fear. Whereas now they might suddenly breathe in his ear. So he thought of his heart, and he thought of his boat, and his hat, and his breeks, and his chickens and goat, and the hooks for his food, and the spring for his thirst. But he never could think which he ought to do first. And so in the end he did nothing at all, but basked on the shingle wrapped up in a shawl. And I think it was dreadful the way he behaved. He did nothing but bask until he was saved.